that having a learning disability just means that we may need extra support to do some everyday things.
I can't understand everything you say. If you give me a big long sentence, it's like I need it cutting down into smaller sentences so I can understand it.
Learning disabilities affect how a person takes in verbal or nonverbal information, how they sort, organize, and retrieve that information, their ability to remember it, and even their level of understanding.
We know our children are not lazy or incapable. Each day they climb a mountain just to get to the starting line. We all need help to understand that their potential is unlimited.
In the Section 504 of the Rehabilitation Act of 1973, equality was a noticeable objective that was important to the policy. In this policy, it would cover the children with learning disabilities, people in the workplace, and any kind of other disabilities, such as handicapped. And this policy is aimed at protecting a student's right to privacy and confidentiality when it comes to the schools. And it also would provide reasonable access to program and services choices that are equal to those available to the general public. So this policy is aimed at providing an equal playing field for children and schools and families. Also for Section 504, another important objective for the policy was discrimination. This policy is a civil rights law that prohibits discrimination against individuals with disabilities. And this policy is aimed at ensuring that children also have equal access, like the objective from earlier, the equality objective. And the child may receive accommodations and modifications to help with any of their problems.
The family involvement would be the third objective of this policy. For our class, Family Law and Public Policy, this policy was much more fitting than some of the other ones that was researched. This policy allows for parents to be involved in the disciplinary action, accommodations process, evaluations process of their children in schools. And this allows for the family to be involved more and their children's education, which is exactly what many parents would like to have, especially when it comes to children that have learning disabilities and disorders or any kind of other disabilities like being handicapped.
The overall social and economic cost of a child with a learning disability and a disorder is around $35,500 per year. Medicaid and special education costs are about $19,700. 94% of children with a learning disability are covered by health insurance and public insurance programs. IDEA provides federal funds to states and local school districts. Section 504 does not provide funding for special education or related services, but it does permit the federal government to take funding away from programs that don't comply with the law.
Family is valued and encouraged to intervene and receive help for the well-being of their children. Section 504 creates for a newfound educational equality and opportunity. It sets the stage for enactment of the Americans with Disabilities Act and Individuals with Disabilities Education Act. And since 2009, eligibility for protection and services became broader. However, because of the absence of funding for Section 504 in many school systems, schools often lack staff with clear responsibility or detailed understanding of how it works. They may have a narrow interpretation of its requirements, which may limit the services and protections aimed by Section 504.
There's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and live.